So hello students and welcome to another video tutorial by Genome Biotech. In this video tutorial, we would be initiating with a chapter that is referred to as cancer of cell biology. Now, what do you mean by cancer? What is cancer? How is cancer being caused? And what are the effects that are being produced the occurrence of a particular cancer? Now, when you talk about the term that is referred to as cancer, or sometimes in a broader sense, you can write a term, you can name a term that is referred to as tumor. Okay, so I'm just writing it out in front of you. The tumors could be actually classified into two different types. Okay, so we can classify the tumors into two different types. One would be referred to as the malignant tumors, and those malignant tumors will be called as cancers. These are malignant tumors. Malignant tumors. Those are referred to as cancers. But when you talk about the other types, the other type is referred to as the benign tumor. Benign tumor that is present is a non-malignant tumor. It is a non-malignant cell that is present. Okay? So that is referred to as a benign tumor, non-malignant cell. Do not shows no angiogenesis, shows no angiogenesis and no metastasis. Okay, there would be no angiogenesis and no metastasis being shown. No angiogenesis. Just a second. No angiogenesis and no metastasis. Angiogenesis and no metastasis. No metastasis. So the exact term that should be used is referred to as tumor. So what is a tumor? Tumor refers to a cell that has lost its control over regulatory mechanisms such as cell division, differentiation, and apoptosis. When a cell loses its control over these three mechanisms, that is its division, how its division is going to take place, how the differentiation of the cell is taking place, and how the apoptosis of the cell is taking place. If a cell loses control over all these three mechanisms, then that cell gets converted into a cancerous cell. This is how cancer is going to be produced. Okay, so that's very important. Now, so tumor is the result of an abnormal proliferation of cell without differentiation and apoptosis. Normal cells always undergoes differentiation as well as apoptosis. But cancer cells never undergoes differentiation and apoptosis. These are the cells that do not undergo differentiation or any apoptosis because they have lost their control over differentiation, development, and apoptosis that is taking place. Okay, so they have lost their usual control over differentiation, development, and apoptosis. So thus, they are becoming tumor cells. Now, tumor cells have been categorized into the benign tumor and the malignant tumor. So these are the two different types of tumors which are present. Now, what do you mean by the benign tumors? Benign tumors are localized tumors. They are localized tumors that remain at a particular site located within the body. Okay? So benign tumor are localized tumors, localized group of cells, localized group of cells found at a particular location in the body, Such type of cells are referred to as the benign tumor cells. For example, if there are blood vesicles that are moving from one side to another, okay, there are blood vesicles, for example, which are moving from one side to the other, then what do you find here is that there are specialized cells and these cells began to divide. Okay, as these cells began to divide, so these cells will increase their number. They began to divide, they would be increasing their number, they would be forming different types of blood vesicles. There would be a cover that would be present over these cells. That cover would be made up of tissue fluid. Okay, there would be a fluid-like substance that would be present, and that fluid-like substance is commonly referred to as the tissue fluid. You can see that this would be an artery, this would be a vein. Now, what is going to happen here is that the innermost cells will be feeling suffocation because of their excessive growth. Now, when the innermost cells will be growing, then what will happen? These cells will feel low oxygen presence around themselves, okay? Because they will feel low oxygen presence, hence will perform anaerobic glycolysis. Anaerobic glycolysis, okay? When they begin to perform anaerobic glycolysis, they lead to the formation of acidic environment around the cell. Acidic environment around these cells. This condition is called as cancer cachexia. This is the first condition which will lead to the development of the particular cancer in a human body. The development of cancer cachexia is the first symptom that will lead to the formation of cancer in the human body. Okay? So this is referred to as the cancer cachexia. Next point that we would be talking about is that how these cancer cells uptakes the blood vesicles. Now, during the anaerobic glycolysis, these cancer cells began to secrete two different factors. Okay, the rapidly dividing cells began to secrete two different factors. One is called as HIF1, hypoxia-inducing factor number one, and hypoxia-inducing factor number two. These are the two factors which are being secreted by these cells. Which are these factors? Hypoxia-inducing factor 1 and hypoxia-inducing factor 2. Hypoxia-inducing factor 1 and 2. These are the two hypoxia-inducing factors which are present. These two hypoxia-inducing factors began to be secreted by those cells which are rapidly dividing. These two factors causes division of the reticuloendothelial lining of the blood vesicle, leading to the formation of a blood vesicle towards the mass of cancer cells. They will be secreted, causing the endothelial lining of the blood vesicles to replicate. The reticuloendothelial lining of blood vesicles to replicate. Okay. Once the blood vesicles will be replicated, then what will happen? A new blood vesicle will be formed towards the mass of cancer cells. See, this factor will cause the formation of a new blood vesicle towards the mass of cancer cells. Then these cancer cells will begin to perform metastasis. Okay. Furthermore, after the formation of this blood vesicle, then the next step will be referred to as the metastasis being performed by these cells, which will detach themselves from all other cells and will move along the bloodstream towards another site in the body, where these cancer cells will further develop another type of cancer. This is how the mechanism of cancer cells operate. Okay, so now on the basis of whether these cells have the ability to perform this act of metastasis or not, they have been classified into the following two different types. Benign tumors. Benign tumors are also referred to as capsulated tumor. कैप्सुलेटेड ट्यूमर, कैप्सुलेटेड ट्यूमर मीन्स दीज रिमेन्स कैप्सुलेटेड विद इन अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया इन द बॉडी. ओके, दे रिमेन प्रेजेंट विद इन अ पर्टिकुलर कैप्सूल एंड देयर लोकेशन इज फिक्स्ड इन द सेल. वेयर एज मैलिग्नेंट सेल, मैलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर्स हैव द एबिलिटी टू मूव फ्रॉम वन लोकेशन टू द अदर. दैट इज व्हाई दीज आर कॉल्ड एज मैलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर. ओके, सो बेनाइन ट्यूमर, व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट बेनाइन ट्यूमर, दीज आर लोकलाइज्ड ग्रुप ऑफ सेल्स फाउंड एट अ पर्टिकुलर लोकेशन इन द बॉडी बिकॉज दे रिमेन्स कैप्सुलेटेड. Neoplastic cells remain clustered together in a single mass and cannot spread to another site. So these are the cells that remains clustered into a particular mass. As these remains clustered into a particular mass, so they cannot move from one site to the other. It contains cells that closely resembles normal cells and that may function like normal cells. So there are cells which are present. And these cells resembles the normal cells. Okay. Next point that we are going to talk about here. Before that, just clearing of all the drawings. Now, the malignant tumors. When you talk about the malignant tumors, what are malignant tumors? These are the tumors that have the ability to perform both angiogenesis as well as metastasis. Okay. So these cells can perform metastasis. Neoplastic cells that do not remain localized and encapsulated and began to become progressively invasive and malignant are described as malignant tumor. These cells began to become malignant in nature. These cells have the ability to move from one location to the other. That is why these are referred to as malignant tumor. Okay, next point. Malignant tumor surrounds normal tissue and thus these have invasiveness present within themselves. Invasiveness refers to the ability to move into the neighboring tissue. These invade surrounding normal tissue and that is why these have invasiveness and spread throughout the body through circulatory system or the lymphatic system in the form of metastasis. Cancer refers to these metastatic cells. Okay, so the term cancer can be referred to these metastatic tumor cells or the malignant tumors which are present. Now, when you classify the benign tumor with the malignant tumor, that what is this benign tumor and what is this malignant tumor, how can we differentiate in between the two? So please look here. See, benign tumor are made up of cells which are very well differentiated. Malignant tumors lacks differentiation because these are rapidly dividing cells. Their growth of rate is very slow and sometimes their growth stops after a particular period of time. For example, in the case of moles, then such type of tumors are referred to as benign tumors. Whereas the other type of tumors, the malignant tumors, have a very rapid rate of growth. Invasiveness is absent in benign tumor. It is present in malignant tumor. Metastasis is absent in benign tumor. It is present in malignant tumor. So these are some of the differences between the malignant and the benign tumors. Both benign and malignant tumors are classified according to the type of cells in which they are present. Most cancer falls into three different types on the basis of the type of cells that are being infected. That is why the cancer can be grouped into three major categories. One is referred to as carcinomas, tumors that arise from endothelial or ectodermal tissues, sarcoma, malignancy of mesodermal connective tissue, and the last is referred to as leukemia. Leukemia is the cancer of the immune system cells, is referred to as the leukemia. So carcinoma is the first one. One is carcinoma, another one is sarcoma, third one is leukemia, okay? So cancer of the endothelial tissue or the ectodermal tissue is sarcoma. Cancer of mesodermal tissue is cancer of the ectodermal or endodermal tissue is carcinoma. Mesodermal tissue is sarcoma. The rarest of all the different types of cancer is sarcoma, less than 2%. Leukemia, lymphoma is the cancer of the blood tissues as well as that of the immune system. One of the most common type of cancers that is present is leukemia and lymphoma. Majority of the cancer arises from a single cell. That is, cancer cells always possess a monoclonal origin present within themselves. Okay? We would be looking at an experiment how the monoclonal origin of cancer was being determined. Okay, cancer are probably initiated by change in the cell DNA sequences. That means these are always being caused by the either by the genetic changes or by the epigenetic changes. Now, what is the difference between the genetic changes and epigenetic changes? Either the entire genomic sequence is being altered or some of the genes pattern of methylation, acetylation, phosphorylation is altered. Okay, there is a gene, you just alter the method of acetylation, phosphorylation and methylation, then it is referred to as an epigenetic changes. Okay, for example, you look here, there is a DNA which is present. And when you look at the DNA, you had a different pattern of methylation, acetylation, phosphorylation. See this, this is methylation. This is methylation. That would be referred to as the methylation pattern. CH3, 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 CH3. This is methylation. Then you add another group. That would be referred to as the acetyl group. Okay? CH3, COO negative. So this will also regulate and alter the pattern of charges that would be present over the DNA. Okay? So one would be methylation, another one would be acetylation or phosphorylation, etc. So those are referred to as the epigenetic changes. Any change within the sequence of the DNA, that is DNA sequence, is referred to as a genetic change or the permanent change within the DNA molecule. Now, next point, most cancer are initiated by the genetic changes. Majority of the cancers are being caused by the genetic changes that takes place within the genetic material of an organism. So when the genetic changes occurs within the material of an organism, then these will lead to the formation of such type of cancer cells. Next. Next point. Most cancers are initiated by genetic changes. Majority of cancers are caused by mutation in somatic cells and therefore are not transcribed to next generation. About 1% of all cancer is due to mutation in the germinal cell and is therefore inherited. About 80% of these inherited cancer are dominant in nature. Majority of the cancers are inherited from one generation to another, and more than 80% of these cancers are being inherited, and these will lead to the formation of several different types of diseases in humans. The transition of a normal cell to a cancerous cell is referred to as transformation. Okay, if you are transforming normal cell into a cancerous cell, then this phenomena is commonly referred to as transformation. The transition from a normal to a transformed cell is a multi-step process and do not take place in a single step. It takes place in several different steps. So the formation of cancer is not a single step process. It requires several different steps which are involved, and those steps are involved in proliferation, invasion, and metastasis. Slowly and steadily, the mutation began to accumulate within the cells, and ultimately these cells gets converted into the tumor cells. The first step in the process is called as tumor initiation. It is the first step in which the process of tumor cancer formation is going to take place. It is a process in which normal cells are changed so that they are able to form tumors. Okay, so when the normal cells are going to be changed, then they are going to form the tumors. Another genetic change occurs within the transformed cells. Additional changes followed by selection of the more rapidly growing cells. This is what I was explaining to you. There is a selection of more rapidly growing cells in the body. As more rapidly growing cells are being selected, so these rapidly growing cells which have been selected will lead to the formation of tumor. Okay, so we can just point this particular thing out. More rapidly growing cells within the population that results in the progression of tumor to increasingly rapid or malignancy situation. Such type of phenomena is called as tumor progression. What happens in the case of tumor progression is that firstly, there is an initiation that has taken place. In the case of initiation, a mutagenic agent causes mutation. either a mutagenic agent can cause the mutation, or the mutations can be induced in the cell by itself. Later on, when the mutations have been induced, these leads to promotion of these cells. There is an increased cellular turnover in the cell. Then it leads to progression, genetic instability takes place, and ultimately it leads to metastasis. That is, tumor formation has taken place in a cell and the invasion of cells takes place from one cell to the other. This is how tumor invasion is going to take place. Next point. Now, in the next point, genetic and phenotypic instability are hallmark of the cancer cells. When you talk about genetic as well as the phenotypic instability, these are the specific hallmark of the cancer cells. These lead to the formation of cancer cells. But their cancer cause is not clear. Why the genetic and phenotypic instability takes place, that is not clear. But these genetic or phenotypic instabilities are being produced in the cell. Okay. So these genetic and phenotypic instabilities which are being produced in a cell can either be caused by exogenous factors or can be caused by the endogenous factors. What do you mean by exogenous factors? Exogenous factors are the external factors that will lead to the formation of mutations. Endogenous factors are the factors of the cells that causes formation of mutation within the body. Next. The ensuring genetic stability drives tumor progression. Once there is a genetic stability, then the tumor progression takes place by generating mutations within the cancer critical genes. These mutant genes provide cancer cells with selectively growth advantage, thereby leading to clonal outgrowth of a cancer. Okay. Mutant genes provide cancer cells with a selective advantage. These have a selective advantage that will grow out into a tumor cells. They gain a selective advantage and then will grow into a tumor cells. Now, properties of tumor cells. Tumor cells have several different types of properties. Density-dependent inhibition. Normal cells have density-dependent inhibition. They will stop after they will reach a particular density. But as the cancer cells never undergoes contact inhibition, so they do not undergo, cancer cell is not sensitive to density-dependent inhibition. Normal cells in culture display density-dependent inhibition of cell proliferation and proliferation until they reach a finite cell density. Once they have reached a finite cell density, they will stop their growth. But cancer cells are not so sensitive. They will not get inhibited after reaching a particular density. Another one is commonly referred to as contact inhibition. What do you mean by contact inhibition? Contact inhibition is a phenomena in which the normal cells, when they are going to come in contact with each other, they are going to be inactivated. Okay. Normal cells migrate across the surface of a culture dish until they come in contact with the neighboring cells. Once the normal cells comes in contact with the neighboring cells, these cells are being inhibited and the normal cells adhere to each other, forming a ordered array of cells on the culture dish. There is an ordered array of cells that is going to be produced because the cells are not going to undergo contact inhibition. There would be no ordered array of cells on the culture dish for the cancer cells. The inhibition is commonly referred to as contact inhibition and is formed in normal cells of the body. Normal cells always undergo contact inhibition, but cancer cells never undergo contact inhibition. Immortalization. Cancer cells lack any normal death in the body. They will not normally die. Normal cells culture do not survive indefinitely. For example, human cell culture can die just about 50 generations. This phenomena in which the human cells are going to die just around 50 generation is referred to as the Hayflick's limit. This is referred to as Hayflick's limit. this is the limit that is present is referred to as Hayflick's limit. And chicken cells culture have a much shorter life expectancy. On the other hand, transformation cell cultures are immortal and these can grow indefinitely. Now, what do you mean by metastasis and invasiveness? Invasiveness and metastasis, as I have already told you. So, the cancer cells have the properties of invasiveness. That is, these can penetrate into the nearby cells. Okay? So, they have the ability to penetrate into the nearby cells. And this phenomena is commonly referred to as invasiveness. Metastasis refers to the ability of the cancer cells, while metastasis refers to the ability of the cancer cell to penetrate into lymphatic and blood vesicles, circulate through the bloodstream, and then invade normal tissue elsewhere in the body. Okay, so these metastasis are going to be performed. These cells are going to invade the nearby tissue and then elsewhere in the body. This is commonly referred to as metastasis. These two properties of the cancer cells leads to the formation of angiogenesis, in which the cancer cells began to produce hypoxia inducing factor number 1 and 2 and lead to the formation of new blood vesicle towards the mass of cancer cell in a phenomena that is commonly referred to as angiogenesis. Once the cancer cells began to be produced towards the mass of cells through angiogenesis, then there would be a rapid division taking place and these cancer cells will be moving from one location to the other. Loss of anchoring dependency. What do you mean by loss of anchoring dependency? Cancer cells shows no anchoring dependency. That means if you are going to look at the cancer cells in the culture medium, they will not be growing directly attached to the substratum. Normal animal cells always gets attached to the substratum and then only grow. Okay, for example, if I'm taking an example, if this is the animal cell culture tube, okay, this is something that is being used in the case of animal cell culture. Just drawing this particular structure. Such type of tube-like structure is being used for the growth of the animal cells. An animal cell is growing in this culture medium. This is a box. And here animal cells are growing. So animal cells, majority of the animal cells will be attached to the basic, to the basement layer. But certain animal cells will be floating. Those animal cells which will be floating in the medium are considered to be dead cells. But in the case of cancer, the cancer cells remains floating in the medium and are never attached to the substratum, as well as these always began to divide. Cancer cells themselves grows and lead to the formation of a mass of cells. These cells themselves divide and lead to the formation of a group of cells or mass of cells within the culture medium. You can look within the pink color. I have shown you certain mass of growing cells. These cells are the cancer cells. Okay? Because these cells never get attached to the basement membrane. Next point. Cancer cells have low serum requirement. They do not require any external nutrient medium. They require very low nutrient medium for their growth and development. These cancer cells also fail to undergoes apoptosis. They do not possess any normal death within themselves. Okay. Then we would be talking about carcinogens from tomorrow and the tumor viruses as well as other different types of carcinogens. We would be looking at Cooper with the introduction up till the failure to undergo apoptosis from the book Cooper in tomorrow's lecture. That's all for today. Hope you enjoyed the lecture. Good night. Bye-bye.